it's Friday morning. It's not raining, which is good. It's bloody cold though, and there's a lot of frost on the ground. So I'm on a path here at the back of Bowhill, which is known to have been part of the old colliery railway. I'm going to follow it up, and then what we'll do is we'll keep going until we come down onto the banks of the River Oar. We'll follow the Oar along, and then we'll come across an old abandoned railway bridge that's there. The tracks are still there, so we'll keep following the tracks and see if there's anything else being left behind by the railway. So a brief history about Bowhill Colliery. The colliery opened in 1895 and ran for 66 years. It had three shafts, pit 1 and 2 were the more successful. Pit 3 really didn't come to much. So obviously the villages developed, you know, the houses were built for the workers. But in 1965, when the colliery closed, you know, the town just obviously became a village of its own. There was a disaster in 1931, where there was an explosion in one of the shafts, and 10 people were killed. So every year we have a memorial service in the village to remember those workers and the other workers that were killed over the lifespan of the colliery.
The dated pictures on Google, the colliery, or the tracks, used to split off into three. But of course, there's been industrial development in the area. There's some sites of a wood chipping plant nearby, which have taken over a lot of that ground, and the rails that were there have all been lifted and taken away. But a section of the track's still there, and that's what we're going to explore today. So what we'll do is we'll go down this path, we'll find the railway that's there, and then we'll follow that and we'll see if there's anything else that's been left behind, as well as the rails. So here we go. Going down this way and up and over this hill and head down towards River Oar. Very muddy underfoot. We may have been frozen out in the open. Certainly among all the bushes and all the long grass, it's still really wet. So coming down the hill here, it's quite a steep incline up there, and it obviously it gets a lot steeper the further we get down, and it was a bit of a kind of steep drop there. So as you can see, the hill climbs up, and that's me holding my phone flat, and you can see how much the hill is going up there. So, and the last time I was down here, I found this nice wee kind of waterfall that had been created. So it's quite difficult to get into during the summer to get some photos of. Because it was all overgrown. It still is good, isn't it? The ground is quite slidey there. And we've got this steep slope. So I climbed up once during the summer. and up there there's these big concrete sheets, broken concrete bits with like steel reinforcement through them. I don't know what they were part of. Never been used to hold the ground, you know, save it for slippings or don't know. But I know that just when we get beyond these bushes here, there's an old railway cart that's embedded in the ground. So it's possibly been a landslide that's come down and claimed this section. We've got the famous pipe that comes along. So we'll go into this wee section here. Here we come. Here we have the old rail carts. They're in the trees. There's actual sections of track, I think, that are in there as well. So you're able to see the wheels. Not on these ones, but the ones that are further along. It's just filled with bricks and stuff. See, there's... No, it's not. It's an intersection of the... under part of the truck. And there's one of the wheels there. If you can see that. One of the wheels. I think it might be a rails, actually. It's just the truck's come off it. It's derailed itself. As it's been knocked off the... knocked off by the landslide. You better look at that one. There's one of them that's just totally disappeared. Mangled mess, that one. Now this is the best one, this butt was in best condition in comparison to the rest. Section of track there, then behind it. I've been here a long time, you know. The trees have all grown around it. Like I say, if there had been a landslide here, then you know, it had fallen on this track, the amount of time it would take for these trees to grow in the carriages or the carts. It's quite a bit. Whoa! Nearly. And if it wasn't for the pipe, it would be an absolutely stunning walk. And it's nice as it is, but you can't help but noticing the big, big pipe that's here. Oh! I was speaking to my mum yesterday. I'm talking about me investing in a pair of good boots as well. The only downside is they're going to cost my fortune because I've got size 13 feet. I'm standing in the pipe now. Around this corner, we'll see the railway bridge. Yes, there it is. Actually, that way, heading off in that direction leads to the main line, and that's the route we're going to follow. And then that way we'd head up to where the colliery was, and then obviously off in that direction, as the diagram showed, the track split into three. Bowhill Colliery was way across that way. So that section of track that the truck that we found in there, probably been. No, maybe not part of that main line, but one of the side branches that's come off, something like that. So obviously the track used to lead off in that direction. And then straight up away, and then off in this direction as well. The section that's left is through here. The trees growing up. Feeling sleepers. There's the river Oar. That leads all the way back to Carlden. It goes under the road at Bowhill.
outside wall of the bridge.
So we'll go down as far as we can, because obviously we'll get to a point that we can't go any further, because it'll come to the main line. But we'll go down as far as we can, and while we're heading down that way, we'll see if there's anything else that's been left behind that we don't know about. Because like I say, I only got so far down here the last time I came, and I had to turn back because it was getting too thick to take the bike through. Moss growing on the rails. Quite dense down here. Maybe stick across this side. There's a wee path that somebody's made. Oh, it's getting really overgrown here. Still see the trap though. It's quite muddy as well. Ow! Ow, ow, ow! These wee things. Ow! Oh, Jesus. Ah! Oh no. Yeah. Stand on it. Well, so far I haven't seen anything else. But then I've been too busy ducking through thorns. Oh, wait a minute. I'm gonna go back this way a wee bit. Jump over this rail. Maybe it's in here. Hmm. In Dutch. Hmm, it looks like it's easier to go through this way. Maybe not. Oh no, I'm gonna get soaked. Oh, it's getting really thick up there. If there is anything in there, it better be special. No way. Ow! Have we not? Get off! No. Maybe I was expecting to see some sort of old signal boxes or something up here. But nothing at the moment. Ow. Oh, there's something. We've got some stones underneath the leaves here. So we're actually getting to the proper track bed. Whereas before it was all just weeds and overgrowth. And under here we've actually got the proper rocks from the track bed. Which should make it a bit easier because hopefully the plants won't be growing through it as much. I can hear a train. Must be getting near the main line. Well, what I said there about the plants not growing through it, spoke too soon. Yeah, it's getting really, really thick now. You still see the track though. Ah.
Oh. I think I've got water in my lens. Water on the screen. It's better.
Uh-huh. And now come to a fence. Track goes on beyond there. There's a wee kind of path that's been created. So pretty much we followed the track all the way down the edge of this field. Yeah, probably would have been easier going along the field, but never mind. It's done now. Yeah, the veil. Yeah. In there and it goes off into these bushes. What we'll do is we'll take a wee walk up here because I can see the main line just now. So we'll take a wee walk up here before trying to venture through all that because it's maybe pointless going through there. Certainly don't see anything through the bushes to suggest that there's any kind of signal box or anything like that through there. There's the main track. So as the diagram I made shows, the track would have come up here and then joins on to the main line. If anybody's able to tell me anything about railways, now maybe we'll tell me what this is. Because I'm just about tripped up over it. I mean the track is there. And this is here. So I don't know if that's actually been part of the railway. Or if it's a bit of farming machinery that's been lost in here. Okay, so I decided to take a shortcut into the farmer's field and follow the fence along, see if I can see anything else over the fence. And I've spotted an old signal growing, trees are growing around it there. This is obviously where the track actually joined on. So I can't get close enough to get a decent look at it because of this barbed wire fence. But it is there. So I'll keep walking down a wee bit and we'll see if we can see that Joel. That's what's joined in the track. I doubt it very much because the signal will be before when the truck comes off. Sun doesn't help. Another day it was too dark, this time it's a bit too light. And there's something there. It's getting taken over by all the bushes. Looks like controls for the junction. Yeah. It is, I can see the handles. The sun wasn't as bright. We'll see them a bit closer. I've walked up the track as far as I could go. Didn't see much more than I knew was there. I knew the carts were there, the track I knew was still there, and the bridge I knew was there. The levers, that was a nice wee surprise. Didn't know they were there. So I'm going to make my way back to the house. I'll be chucking my sambas in the bin, I think. Please like and subscribe, and I'll catch you later.